1970s kids going rebelling and destroying a high school. And they also wanted to reference the Ramones Rock and Roll High School. And so I took pieces of what they talked about and liked the idea of the whole thing taking place in the high school gymnasium. And basically nobody wanted to be there for more than like half an hour. And I needed them there for 12 hours. So by the 11th hour when the band had had it with me and the kids were so angry and, you know, and just wanted to get out of there, I said, listen, can we destroy the set? And I'm exhausted. I'm like, all right, fine, destroy the set. What do I care? It's like, you know, just destroy it. So all the kids came down from the stands and it's all real. You know, the last 30 seconds of that video is those kids really destroying the set. And I just happen to have a roll of film in the camera and I look through the eyepiece and I go, that's it. You know, the light bulb, that's amazing. And filmed it and it became the end of the video. And so yeah, those kids were not from Central Casting, and the destruction and the rebellion and everything at the end of that video, it's just real. There was a point during the video, I think Kurt had performed the song like 3 or 4 times and didn't want to do it anymore. And I had to go up to the record company and say, look, he's got to do it a couple more times or I don't have a video. And what I remember is, and I think what makes it a really strong video is, and I'd like to believe, and is that Kurt was so mad about being there. It really was like the takes that we forced him to do that became the, when he's putting his face into the camera, like so close that it's out of focus and screaming into the lens. He was really pissed off about being there. And it's like, you know, there's a part of me that like, I'm sorry I had to do this to you, but wow, what a great performance, you know? I had a cut of the video that had some other stuff in it that looking back, it just wasn't that good. There was other characters from the high school gym, the principal, and other kind of like very music video cliche stuff and that was in the video. And Kurt was really unhappy about it, and he flew down from Seattle. It was the last time I ever saw him, and sat in the edit bay with me and made some brilliant decisions. And like during the guitar solo, he's like, I don't want to see the guitar, so I want to see my hands on the wrong place on the guitar. And he was a smart guy, you know? It's like, he was a really smart guy. Everything, you know, it was, in all the years since then, anytime I dealt with an artist, it was about vanity. It was about, what do I look like? He didn't care what he looked like. He cared about that the video had something that was truly about what they were about. It literally lifted me out of obscurity and jump-started my career, and it never would have happened like that with another band or another video. It was like, for me, it was everything.
Got some roof, haven't told, promise you. I remember one night sitting in our apartment with Kurt, and I think Kris was there too, and there was a special on TV on underwater birth. We went to meet with the artwork people, and we said, yeah, we saw this thing on TV last night, these babies underwater, and it kind of seemed sort of cool. And we got, he said, well, I'll look for a picture. I'll see if I can find one.
You know, went out searching, you know, books and stuff. And I think every picture that I found was just, you know, like way, way too graphic and gnarly for, you know, to be used on a cover. There's no way it could be, you know, done. But I found a stock image of a baby swimming underwater that I, you know, I cut out and I proposed to the band, and he really liked that. So we kind of went from there on that. The photographer, Kurt Weddle, set up to shoot at, I think it was a Pasadena swim school. And he went there like maybe the week before and enlisted a bunch of parents to bring their kids down.
My mom was good friends with this guy, Kirk Weddle. He shot the album cover. He called my mom up and said, we need someone to do the job. And I guess that was me, because I was just born and it was a baby that they needed. I'm basically the Nirvana baby.
It all kind of fell together really organically. Like, you know, we got the picture of the baby, and then we kind of went back and, you know, we were, okay, it's got to be something more. So we started, you know, thinking of different ideas. And I think he came up with the fishhook idea. And then we spent, you know, like hours just kind of joking around all the different funny things you could put on the fishhook, and end up being a dollar bill.
Kurt was very clear on what he wanted to do with the cover. You know, he had it in his mind. He knew what he wanted it to say. And I think that, you know, in everything that he did as an artist, you know, it had something to say, you know. And it was really funny at the time. Well, it was interesting at the time, because, you know, no one took any heed to the cover at our company. Like, this will be a problem or whatever. And then the record blew up quickly, and then it was like, well, Walmart won't take this, you know. And we were like, well, who cares, you know? Like, we're not going to make a different cover, because, you know, you could take your driver's license and go into Kmart or Walmart and buy an AK-47, but they wouldn't take an album cover with, you know, a baby's penis on it.
A couple places where they started getting feedback, you know, like the radio shows about, you know, how it was like, you know, disgusting pedophile thing. And, you know, it's just, and then there was like the big, we had the big posters that went in record store windows, and they were putting stickers over, you know, the private area and stuff.
I think it was Ventura, where a record store had a big 4x4 blow up of the album cover in the window. And a cop came by and made them put a post-it over the genitals, you know, fig leaf, basically.
And I think that it's so fitting to look back, you know, having not given any thought, that album, which was so powerful and so, you know, so influential and will be for generations to come, has a baby on the cover, because it's kind of the birth of a lot of different things at the time. It'll probably be the birth of a lot of different things in the future.